My name is Sudeshwar Rai, and in this video, I am going to explain for loop. If you are new to my channel, I'll request you, please subscribe my channel because time to time I upload the new videos and you can watch it, right? In this video, I will explain about the for loop because I have already explained about the while and do while loop. And if you'd like to watch that video, you can check in this video description. I'll put the link over there, right? And otherwise you can go in a playlist and you'll be able to see the all the videos over there, right? So let's discuss about the for loop. I have already discussed as while and do while, and I told in the previous video that there are three things which you need to keep in mind if you're working on these three types of loop, and that is variable initialization, condition, increment or a decrement, right? So let's directly do the implementation of the for loop, then you'll be able to understood the thing. So here, this is the main method where I'm going to implement the for loop. So the syntax of the for loop is you will have to write the for loop, and here you will have to declare the first initialization which you have seen this part, variable initialization. And then what I need to do here, you can put the condition, okay, I is less than 10, right? Then the third one, which is the increment or a decrement, and that will go here. Increment and decrement means loop, I mean the while, do while and the for loop work in a backward as well as the forward mode, right? So here I am going to write, okay, I am going to print the I value here. Let's understand this for loop, how it is behaving, how it is working. So this is the step number one. Once your code will be executed, it will come here. This is the step number one. It will, this piece of, I mean, this line will be only entertained one time. It will just get the value, okay, I value is a one. Okay, it will move to the this step. This is the step number two. It means it will come here and it will check, okay, I value is the less than 10, then directly control will be moved to the this one. It will print the result and then it will move to the step number four, which is this one. So step number one, this, step number two, this, step number three, this, and step number is the four is this. Again, step number five will be this, and then this, and then this. This sequence will be continue. You'll be able to see this has been entertained only one time. So this is the way which the for loop is a follow, and it will process, I mean to say that it will execute. Let's see here. So I have executed it, and see, as earlier I told you, step one, see step one, this is the step two, and this one is will be the step three. Then again, this is the step four, this is the step five and six and seven and so on. So this is the way which for loop follow, and it will show the result 1 to 9, right? Now, if you like to implement the nested loop in the for loop, so you can implement like this. Again, you will have to do the variable initialization, which is the I is equal to I, j is equal to 1, and this j is less than, like you have given the 5, right? Then j will be increment, and see here it will print the j value, right? Let's write here the text something, so it will be easy for us to identify. Value of I is, which is this, and the same, let's copy this piece of the code, this piece of the text here, and let's paste it here. Just change the value of is, okay, value of I is and value of j is, right? Now once we'll execute, so how it will work, once this one will be executed first time, I mean once the step one, step two, once step three will become, in that point this one, this loop will complete the whole cycle. What it means, it means that before going to the I value two, I mean once second time it will be executed, before second time this one will complete the complete cycle. Like j value will be print 1 to 4, then I value will be print 2, then again j value will be print 1 to 4, then again I value will be print 3, and then again 1 to 4, and then I value will be 4, and then again 1 to 4, and so on. It will continue, right? Let's execute and show you the result. So see here, once it has come here the first time, right? See, it is going to complete the whole cycle. See, it is repeating again and again, again and again. See, right? Once it has complete the cycle, again it will go to the parent one, right? And see, again it will complete the whole cycle, and you'll be able to see the output like this. If I is a one, sorry, let me show it to you. So you can check here, I value is one, then see j 1 2 3 4, again I is a 2 1 2 3 4 j, right? 1 2 3 4, I is 3, again j 1 2 3 4, and so on, right? So this is about the for loop. I hope you have enjoyed this video, right? If you have enjoyed, please subscribe my channel and share into your friend list so they can also get to know. And I think this video will be definitely a good for the freshers, right? So if you know someone who is a fresher, you can share this video with him, right? Thank you so much for giving your time, and I am going to see you in the next video. Okay, thank you.